the subject I am dealing with today is all about the user factor. What is that? What I am going to talk about right now, and let me introduce that first. So there is something that we always tend to ignore while developing software. That we are developing softwares and applications for human beings. So try to make our environment more like user conscious development. So what I'm going to talk about right now today is more simple, like it is all about why, what, and how. This is a simple way to deal with such very philosophical things. Like what I'm talking here right now is not that like presented earlier. They have subject, they have code to show, they have everything to show like that. So this is something like a philosophy or a culture that we need to follow. So I'm trying to get use of a lot of images and a lot of other stories to explain this philosophy. So and I have just split my presentation into three parts. Why UI design, and what is UI design, and the common terms that we hear in this industry, and how to do good UI designing, and what we are doing. That's what I have explained in that section. So let's start with that. So in the why section, I have this wonderful picture here, which I'm trying to explain. Like this is all about show business. The why we are doing designing, why we are designing our interfaces, why we are designing the UI, why we are designing everything. So this is something like the human character to get attracted to designs. So whatever we see a wonderful thing, we see a beautiful thing, we get attracted to that. While a peacock is dancing, I'm sure that 10 people will be around that watching that wonderful dance. So this is basically a very, very common, natural thing that people used to attract to good designs. So we do UI design also to attract people into a UI and hold them in the UI. So the second point I'm stating here is good UIs always make a trust in the users. Like if you are in a UI which is properly aligned, properly designed, properly colored, properly sensibly designed, and properly informative, and properly everything is perfect, then you will trust that UI. Why do you need to trust some UI? I'm trying to show you some example where we trust UI. So this is a payment screen where you see everything is okay in order and informations are there and you have all those things. You will not doubt to enter your credit card number into a UI like this. Okay, this is fine. But in the next case, which I'm saying is the same UI, I'm trying to my level best to make it as messy as possible. Please excuse me if you feel this is a good UI. Okay, so when you see this, this is totally an amateur UI. So people will think, is this a real thing or a fake, or somebody is trying to fake me out? So you will not trust this UI. You will not trust this UI. That means you will not trust this service or you will not trust this product. So basically that relates to the end service or product. So That's why we give importance to UI design in lot of area, in application design or web application design. So the third thing I'm going to state here for why we design is basically we like good design. We always try to design things around us. Like whenever you are at home, whenever you are at the office desk, if you try to decorate your space with good designs, like flowers, like a good painted wall, or a nice bookshelf, you order it. Even if you are not a person of that kind, I'm sure that you have somewhere in your mind would like to see your room like this. Am I right? If I'm wrong, please correct me. So I can't do like this, but it's a dream that I always like to see my room like this. So this is like, we all like designs. That's why we design. So now we are getting into the second section of my presentation, that is, what is UI design? We hear a lot of terminologies related to UI design in the current world. Like some people say, when people come to me for come to INAP for interview, we can see them keeping in the first column, like, I'm a UI expert, I'm a UX expert, I'm a user experience designer. So what is that? Why we have all these different terminologies for inside the UI, and what is what? So let us sort it out. Let's see. So first we will start with user interface design. What is interface design and what is all that about? For me, I'm doing interface design for web applications and web pages and applications, standalone applications for mobile applications and things like that. We have seen, we are related to the IT field, so we are doing UI for IT related services. That is mostly into the browser or a device or whatever. But things are different in some other areas. Like, all these are interfaces, like you deal with a TV, television, with a remote. I'm dealing with the laptop with this remote. This is an interface. So a remote is an interface to deal with a system. So in this theory, UI design is a process of creating an interface for user to interact with the system. It's a very simple theory that it's a, so UI interface, like user interface is an interface to interact with a system. That can be anything, like a plane, you have a cockpit, that is also an interface. You have something else, like that person is like trying to trying to operate a machine with the interface in her hand, that is also an interface. So these are all interfaces, user interfaces, but what we deal with is all about user interfaces for web and mobile applications and things like that, all IT related interfaces. So look at the user interface in a very broader sense, it will look like this. Like, everything is an interface. You deal with a lot of interfaces from morning to evening. You deal with a lot of such kind of devices and interfaces. So, what is interaction design? Interaction design is something like more like a designing a system, a communication system or an interacting system that not just involves user interface, graphical user interfaces, which involves other things like a customer desk, where customer directly deals with the customer and interact with the customer and takes data and gives information. So that is also an interface. So there also interaction is happening. So in a whole system, if there is a company, so we are going to deal all those things in this system. So we are going to enter the data of the user in a system. So how they are going to take the data? They are going to interact with the customer directly like this, and there will be a computer in front of her, and she will be collecting the data from the user and will be entering the data in the user. So now the user is different. User is a person in the customer desk, and user is actual person who is giving the data is on the other side of the desk. So the old system, this kind of interaction system we design in a whole company or a whole, if it's a gas booking, you may have all deal with gas booking systems. Different companies deal differently. Intend in our area deal in a different way. They give a bill first, then they will send you with that bill to the godown and let you take the show the bill to that person there and take the. So this interaction methodology is totally different in different areas. So this is kind of a planning. This is kind of a plan. It's all about a plan of interaction and handling of interaction data. So is there any question? You can directly shoot it to me, like if you have any dissent, you don't agree with all these factors, because I have never googled anything to make these slides, and just these are all my came out of my thoughts. So user experience design, as you see that person in that bill, what he is experiencing right now. So so it's all about a kind of total feeling of a person towards a product, or a total feeling of a collective feeling of a user towards a product or a service. It's not just like this particular functionality is very user experience rich. No, you can't say it. User experience only you can say in a product level or a service level. So it's a collective feeling that user gets after using a product or service, after using a series of interfaces to interact with the system. So that's how we reach, like we use Google, for example, we use Google, we use all their services. We use an Android phone, we use Google Calendar, we use Google Drive. I'm using a Google presentation, like Google Drive. So this is all collaborated. Like I was just preparing this presentation live inside my system, and I'm here with my presentation without, like I was collaborating with Renjit's system. So it's all like an experience that Google gives, unique experience that Google gives with their different products and different ideas, like new kind of ideas and things like that. So this is an experience that we have from Google. And one more thing I just want to say about user experience is user experience is always relative. Why I'm saying this? Because somebody who has never used Google, okay, somebody who has never seen Facebook or Google, can you imagine somebody? Is there anyone who not have a Google account or Facebook account here? No. But there are people in this world who don't have a Google account or a Facebook account. And we always deal with such people when we are dealing with having a new UI for a new software, for an old software. So currently they are using this software and they want a new UI. You give all these features of Google into this new UI, and that person is totally wondered, what is this? I was using a Foxboro application very nicely, and this is totally weird for me. So such kind of things come, like the user experience is very much relative. When you give a rich user experience to a user who is not exposed to that much rich user interface, then you fail to satisfy the user. So there you have to consider the user's user experience. The user is not, that's a relative factor. Like, you should consider the users, the end users' user experience also well designed. So this is from a user interface designer's perspective. You should consider the user's user experience while designing the UI. That's a very important thing. Otherwise, you will fail to satisfy. So what is UCD and CCD? It is like a CMO processor, all these things are created, CCD, UCD. So it's very simple, user-centric design, UCD. And other thing is content-centric design. That is also a very simple ideology. User-centric design is something like a tool which the need is the users, you want to book a ticket in IRCTC. Okay, you want to book a ticket in IRCTC, that's your need. So you want to get into the IRCTC site and you want to get your task done as quickly as possible. So UI designer should take care of the user who is sitting on that end. Okay, that is the person who is booking the site, booking the ticket. So we should make the task as easy as possible. We should make everything secure as easy as possible. So that is a kind of user-centric, you should deliver user-centric design. And the process of user-centric design, we have a different methodology to approach such UI designs. So the second thing is content-centric design, which is more about like in-app website or the websites that we are currently inaugurated here, which is more like what the other side, like the in-app want to tell to the user or the target user, like we are offering this service, please consider. So the need is of the of in-app to like this is our need to expose our products and services to the target user. So we, as a designer, need to consider the key selling points of in-app and project it in front of the site. So the user need to consider in this case is the key selling points of in-app or the what the in-app want, hear to the in-app people and hear what they want to sell. So the other case, the thing is different, the user is the main person that he needs to consider. Very simple. And now we are getting into the third section of the presentation, that is how to deliver a good design. And I will just quickly go through this because this is something what we do daily in in-app. This is how you know, like identify the target user. So identify the target user, the age, gender, location, and everything of the user. Try to get as much information as possible before you start the design. Because if you are designing for an old person and you are designing for a young person or a young generation crowd, then it should be different, right? You don't you feel that? So it should be different, like the font size, the colors that you use, and the location is also very important. Like we designed for Japan as well as US people. Like Japan people need more light, soothing colors, and it's all like location specific. And US people, you can always predict. Most of the sites we see in the internet are like default US specific. Okay, when you are developing the website, when you are through the developing process, always keep in mind about the user perspective. Whenever you get a functionality, whenever you talk about a new thing, just keep in mind about the user perspective always. So the requirement analysis from user's perspective should be done. At higher levels, people used to have 5 more minutes to go. So, okay, higher level people used to do case studies before starting any UI related things, and they used to put a lot of effort and money into that. So, some in our like we don't do that much of case studies and all. So we just do minimal setup. We can just gather following information like what would the user want from the system, how would system fit in the user normal case. These are all things that I talked, that I said right now without all those things. So for once you gather all those things, how do you confirm that you are right? How do you confirm that you are in the right track? You are thinking in the right way than the user is. So you create prototypes. Rapid prototypes with your hand, or you have a lot of Kaku, like Kaku is a tool that we use for prototyping. There are a lot of tools around, so you can use those tools and try out these things. So prototyping really helps you to confirm that you are on the right track. Just share it with the client and get it, have a call and get it approved. So that's the way we do. Information architecture is something that we like to do, but we do in different other ways. Like this is like dealing with all those things, storyboarding, workflows. We do it for Empress. We do workflows in real time. Like we do HTML workflows and show it to the client. So this is something very very interesting for the testing team. Maybe like this is the usability review. Okay, this is something we don't, we don't do consciously, and we don't spend this much of time and effort for usability testing. But we do it in a very different offline manner. We have the experts in our company. We have people who are industry for 15 20 years, so it's like naturally we can consult them and just get it done, or we just get it approved from the client. That's what we do. But in the real-time scenario, let me explain what happens. Like a functionality is done, the workflow is put in front of a user who is sitting in a dark room, okay, spotlighted. And all the developers will be sitting like this, and the user will not be able to see them. And one person will be there with him to assist. And this person will be working with that, going through that UI samples. And mostly, what happens is the project manager sitting on the other side says, oh, you click on that. That button is there. The design says, why can't you see that button? That is so big there. So the way the user thinks, the way the user want things may be different. So after doing such a test, maybe you can try to understand the user better and deliver it a better UI, which makes everything easy for you. So this is almost, get me almost the final slides. Like with all the above information, we can do a better UI. The final thing is to start UI development, and in each and every stage, the user conscious thing, the philosophy should work out in all of our mind. Like, is this needed for the user? If not, please try and educate things like from the user perspective. That's what I'm trying to do all these days. and the from the graphic designing part, I believe in this, like, perfection is never accidental. We cannot find perfection in an accidental manner. It's a conscious and continuous effort that a designer makes to make things perfect. Then only it will look perfect. And perfection always brings the feeling of professionalism. So then people say, oh, that site is really professional. So this is the way to reach that position where people say you are professional UI designer.